Blood typing. Materials: synthetic blood and antisera, blood trays, toothpicks, wax pencil, and a waste container. The wells on the blood trays are pre-marked. Be sure to put each antisera into the correct well. Pick up a blood tray and check to see that it's right side up. Use the wax pencil to mark the tray. For this demo, I'll mark it with the blood type, A negative. Place a small amount of blood in each well. Recap each bottle as you go. Find Antisera A. It's this blue one. And put 2 drops into the A well. Make sure to never let the tip of an Antisera bottle touch the blood drop. Pick up Antisera B, the yellow one, and put 2 drops into the B well. Pick up Antisera D, the clear one with the white label. Antisera D tests for the Rh factor, so it goes into the Rh well. Use a toothpick to stir the A well for several seconds. Spread the blood around in the well. This end has been used, so it's contaminated, but we can turn it around and use the clean end to stir another well. Since both ends are contaminated, we'll dispose of the toothpick. Use a second toothpick to stir the last well, then dispose of it. Saving it to use the other end later could contaminate the workspace and might lead to a mistake that contaminates the next sample. Results for type A negative. The key to checking for clumping or agglutination is to tilt the tray back and forth for several seconds. Here we can see large distinct clumps in the A well and no clumping in the B or Rh wells. Let's repeat that process with the B positive sample. I'll label the tray with the wax pencil B+. Put a small amount of blood into each well. Add 2 drops of Antisera A to the A well, remembering not to touch the tip to the blood drop. Add 2 drops of Antisera B to the B well. And add 2 drops of Antisera D to the Rh well. Stir one well with a toothpick. This end is contaminated, but I'll turn it around and stir the next well with the clean end. This is contaminated, so I'll dispose of this one and get a new one to stir the last well. Results for type B positive. I'll tilt the tray back and forth. I see lots of very small clumps in the B well, but notice the Rh well shows agglutination too. It's harder to see because fewer of the synthetic blood cells are trapped in the clumps. Comparing the two wells, you can see clear areas in the B well that make the clumps stand out. In the RH well, the clumps are kind of hidden. That's why we tilt the blood trays. Now we'll repeat for type O negative. Get a clean tray and make sure the well openings are face up. I'll label it with the wax pencil. Put a small amount of blood into each well. Recap the bottle. Add 2 drops of Antisera A to the A well. Two drops of Antisera B to the B well. And 2 drops of Antisera D to the RH well. Stir one well with a toothpick. Make sure to spread it around to cover the well. This end's contaminated, so I'll turn it around. Discard that toothpick and get a clean one. Stir the last well, and then discard the toothpick. Results for type O negative. Tilting the tray, the blood in all 3 wells appears smooth and even. Remember how positive and negative results look. Here's a picture of all 3 of the demo blood trays. A negative shows agglutination only in the A well, B positive shows agglutination in the B and RH wells, O negative shows no agglutination.